Hey guys, welcome back. There's another stable Pi update rolling out now for OnePlus 5 and 5T. The new OS version is 9.0.1 and the update is being directly pushed to users running Oreo 5.1.7, and yes, couple of users from India are also getting it. So if you're one of those users who didn't get the 9.0.0 Pi update last week, then check for updates and see if the OTA is available for you. Although it's an incremental update, for now it's only a full ROM, as the users who are currently running 9.0.0 Pi didn't get any OTA update. Even I have tried changing my location to other countries via VPN, but none of it worked. The full ROM size is 1748 MB, and this is a bug fix update which adds a couple of stability improvements for the network and optimizations for the display. So if you're upgrading to Android Pi for the first time, then I would suggest you to take a backup of everything on your phone. I mean the important things like the pictures and videos, because there are a lot of phone boot loop reports after upgrading to Android Pi, and sadly it is happening even through the direct OTA method. It is fine if you have an unlocked bootloader, but if you have a locked bootloader, then the only way to revive your phone is with the Unbrick tool, as you can only boot to the fast boot mode and not the recovery mode. In case if you are one of those who bricked your phone, then I have added a link for the video guide to unbrick your phone in the description below. Also, you can make use of the OnePlus Switch app to take a backup of the launcher, apps, app data, pictures and videos on your phone. Once the backup is done, transfer the OP backup folder from your phone's internal storage to your secure location on your computer. So here I've used the local upgrade method. To do it, transfer the ROM package linked in the video description to your phone's internal storage, then go to Settings, System, System Updates, gear icon at the top right corner, local upgrade, and the pick the ROM you want to flash and hit upgrade now. OTA 42 version is for Android Pi 9.0.0 and the OTA 43 is for 9.0.1. Also, you can use the stock recovery to flash the Pi ROM. Enable advanced reboot options from the developer options, then boot to the recovery from the power menu, or press and hold volume down and power button simultaneously until you see the OnePlus logo. Now enter the lock screen pattern to decrypt, select the desired language, install from internal storage, pick the ROM file and select yes. So once you have flashed the ROM successfully, go back to the recovery home screen, select wipe data and cache tab, wipe cache and hit yes. Wipe cache is not mandatory, but some users are having issues with downloading apps from the Google Play Store, and this should help fixing it. If you're still facing app download issues, then long press on the Google Play Store icon on the home screen, app info, storage tab, and here clear storage, and do the same thing for the Google Play Services app too by going to settings, apps and notifications, see all apps, Google Play Services, storage, clear storage and clear all data. Now reboot your phone once and then let the Play Store app update automatically or do it yourself. So as you can see, the OxygenOS version is 9.0.1, Android version is Pi, security patch level is of December 1 and the build date is December 29. Next, if you are unable to get the new swipe up navigation bar or the new horizontal recents menu, then go to the settings, apps and notifications, see all apps, OnePlus launcher, storage tab and clear storage. Now open Google Play Store and update the OnePlus launcher app and it should fix everything. Now getting to the update changelog, this update improves stability for the Wi-Fi connection, but still some users are having issues with some apps like Netflix or Twitter, especially if you are using a broadband connection via router. Next, they have fixed issue with 4G VLT toggle missing from the menu, optimizations for the sRGB display mode, some other optimizations for the display reading mode, and finally they have fixed random reboots when screencasting feature is being used. Additionally, now screenshot sound disable option is working, but the camera stutter still makes sound even after switching it off from the camera settings. The camera app is the same, has front portrait mode but no nightscape mode. Next, the ROM pauses safety net check, no issues with the mic. DRM level is L3, and if you want to get it updated to L1, then visit any OnePlus service center near your location, and there is no audio tuner support for the Bluetooth earphones yet. So overall the ROM is stable apart from some Wi-Fi issues, but if you are still facing issues after doing everything, then I would suggest you to take a backup of everything and reset the system settings within the stock recovery, especially if you have recently upgraded to Android Pi from Oreo 5.1.7. About benchmarks, NT2 version 7 score is 211,375 with Geekbench 4, single core and multi-core scores are 1957 and 6734. So that's pretty much it for now. Thanks for watching and wish you all a very happy new year.